Hi everyone, Chef from Outdoors in the Low Countries. Now in this video we're going to remove some stuff using the Kubota P2261, the front loader and some implements. So let's go. Now I want to remove some stuff. First, these poles that have been used to support this tree. They don't need it anymore. Tree is now long enough in the ground to support itself. So I will take them out. I tried already to get them out, but it doesn't really work. So I'm going to see if we can use the Kubota for that. But first of all, I want to see if I can take out this playhouse from the kids. They've grown up, so they don't use it anymore. Standing here for quite a while. There were also some other construction attached to it. That's already removed, but now I still need to remove that one. First, I will use the forklift to see if I can lift the whole construction up and then remove it. And second to that, I will try to remove the poles. I think I will use the Rhino Ripper for that, but that's something that we'll see. So first, the playhouse. Forks at this moment are too wide, so what I will first need to do is to reduce the space in between so they can go underneath. So this should do it. So now let's see if you can lift the whole construction up. So now you can clearly see why it's always a good idea to have a high security guard on your pallet fork construction. Now for taking out the poles, I want to use the Rhino Ripper. So we will first take off the pallet forks and then have the front loader take up the Rhino Ripper to move forward. So after removing the playhouse, there are still some leftovers from the poles in the ground, small stumps. Now the best way to remove that is using the Rhino Ripper. So let me demonstrate you that it works well also to remove stumps from poles. Thank you. So apparently there was only one stump. The only thing I could dig up was some loose parts of wood, but not a real stump. But at least it's out now, so that's good. So let's now take out the poles. Now let's make a clove hitch and take it out. Put the screwdriver in so I can easily untie the nut. Now this went very well, so the Kubota with the front loader and some implements, they really make your life easy. And with those knots it's very easy to tie them and to take them apart as well. So one down, three to go. So you see, it's really good to have those holes, because then you can tie a rope onto it and use the Rhino Ripper for more than only removing stumps. So let's do it again, making a clove hitch, or a mast warp as we say in Dutch. There it is, and we're going to connect it towards the Rhino Ripper using a reef knot, or plattenknoop as we say in Dutch. Connect to the ripper, making a reef knot. Like this. Let's take it out. So this one showed some resistance, but yeah, no way you can win from a Kubota, of course. Let's untie. And only one to go. So you see that the Kubota compact tractor, together with the front loader, is a very nice tool to remove some stuff. I used the Rhino Ripper to remove some stumps and some poles. It's an implement that I made myself. You can see a video of how I made it on my channel, or you can remove stuff with the pellet forks. And as you can see, removing a playhouse is even fun to do. Now also this implement, by the way, I made myself. This video of how I made it is not yet on my channel, it will follow soon. I have still some quite some video editing to do to have it shortened in, because of all the welding and the cutting and the things like that, but it will come. And you see that also this is a very nice implement to work with, together with the Rhino Root Ripper, to remove stuff and to do nice things in the outdoors. So I hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching. See you next time.